Assalamualaikum and hi. So we continue back on 10 frequency response theory part 3. So this is the last theory, number 10, complex zeros and poles. If we have this complex function either at numerator for zeros or at denominator for poles, please do not factorize, just leave it as this second order polynomial functions. So we replace as with j omega to convert into the frequency domain. And we rearrange until we get plus 1 at the end without S function. So in order to have this one, we need to divide this one by 100. And be careful this one not divide by 100 since it's squared. So divide by 10. So 10 squared become to 100. And multiply this function with 100 in order to get the same equation as this one. So this time is the natural frequency, or in complex numbers, we call it natural frequency omega n. But this is actually cutoff frequency. So we go for example a complex zeros. Let's see if we have this one at numerator. So we have complex zeros. We rearrange until we get this format plus 1 at the end. So the cutoff frequency is 10. For magnitude, the starting point is 0 dB. For frequency lesser than the cutoff frequency 10, the slope is 0 dB per decade. For frequency larger than 10, the slope is positive 40 dB per decade. The slope is positive because it is 0. The slope is 40 instead of 20 because it has double 0. So positive 40 dB per decade until the end of the frequency. That is for magnitude. And now for phase, the starting point is 0 degree. We need to determine the frequency range based on the cutoff frequency. So the cutoff frequency is 10. We extend 1 decade before the cutoff frequency, divide by 10. So we have 1, and we extend 1 decade after the cutoff frequency using this formula. So it is 100. So within this frequency range, only the slope has non-zero slope. In this case, positive 90 degree per decade. Positive because it is zero function. 90 degree per decade instead of 45 degree per decade, because we have double zeros. In this case, two zeros. So out of this range lesser than 1, the slope is 0 degree per decade, and larger than this frequency range, which is larger than 100, the slope is 0 degree per decade. The next one is complex poles. If we have this function at denominator, just leave it as this. Do not factorize, replace S with j omega. Rearrange until we have plus 1 at the end, and we divide by 100. And this one, be careful, we divide by 10. So 10 squared, we got 100, and this function we multiply with 100 so that we will have the same function as this one. So for complex poles, for magnitude, the starting point is 0 dB. This is the cutoff frequency. For frequency lesser than 10, the slope is 0 dB per decade. For frequency larger than 10 until the end, the slope is negative 40 dB per decade. The slope is negative because it is pole. The slope is 40 because it has double poles. So the slope is negative 40 dB per decade for frequency larger than cutoff frequency until the end. For phase, the starting point is 0 degree. And this is the frequency range, 1 decade before the cutoff frequency using this formula, and 1 decade after the cutoff frequency using this formula. So within this frequency range only, the slope has non-zero slope, which is negative 90 degree per decade. Negative because it is poles, and 90 degree per decade instead of 45 because it has double pole. So the slope is negative 90 degree per decade only within this frequency range. For frequency less than 1, the slope is 0 degree per decade. For frequency larger than 100, the slope is 0 degree per decade. So that's all for 10 frequency response theory. We continue the next lecture on stability analysis for dot plot or frequency response. Thank you very much.